the wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. ES News.
ES News, stay tuned. It's your boy Andy Emilio coming to you with a lot of dope interviews. Be patient. We got Deontay Wilder, Sean Porter, weigh-ins, face-offs, all that coming at you, baby.
Oh, you got the co-sign for Sean Porter for standing for you to get in the ring. Who do you got, Brian Jennings, Luis Ortiz?
I got Brian Jennings.
You got Jennings?
Ortiz is a heavy hitter, but, you know, Brian Jennings, man, I know the guy. I got nothing but respect for him, what he can do. He's got skills. He's a heavyweight, but he's got more skills at that heavyweight weight class division than most guys have. So I put his skills against anybody.
Now I know there's a million politics, but for the casual fan, I'm sure this will be a fantasy fight they would love. There's still a little bit of, you know, room in there. They're not sure on who's going to be the final opponent for Manny Pacquiao.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
You know, so like, I mean, I kind of heard maybe Tim Bradley, maybe Terrence Crawford, Amir Khan. I mean, is that a fight that you would have wanted?
I heard Terrence Crawford. I was like, I don't think that fight's going to happen. You know, nobody really wants to see Bradley Pacquiao 3.
Even after the Rios knockout?
No.
Do you think that was like a washed up Rios, or was that a really good Bradley?
Really good Bradley.
Really good Bradley?
Really good Bradley. He looked good. Really good Bradley. I really wouldn't say it was a washed up Rios, but he hadn't been in the ring for a while.
You think Rios comes back, or is he really retired?
I think he comes back.
I think he comes back.
You know, on second thought, that might be a good fight, you know what I mean? But I was salty at the first decision of Pacquiao Bradley.
Okay.
And then I thought the second decision was a little more fair. But, you know, I just think that fight, it's been there, done that.
Is that a fight that Sean Porter would look for?
Yes.
Sean Porter, Manny Pacquiao?
Yes, sir.
What would that fight look like?
Bradley, too. He knows that.
All right.
So he knows that.
Everybody.
Yeah, I joked with him when I was at the Boxing Expo. I was, you know, acting like I was taking his belt from him. But we nothing but respect, but that's greatness against me. You know what I mean? I consider Timothy Bradley to be one of the great fighters of our generation. And I would love to be in the ring against him.
Is that kind of bittersweet that there's these great champions with all these other promoters?
For me, it is.
That you can never, with a guy like you who got that warrior spirit, you don't care anything about the politics.
Yeah.
You just want to get in the ring with the best.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Like, is it like, damn, I wish I could just, you know, fight these guys in a parking lot or something, you know? Like, let's just get it together.
Yeah. We joke like that. We'll do it anytime, any place.
Yeah.
But we understand that, you know what I mean? It's somebody, you want to do it in the right place, you know? But at the same time, it is a bittersweet thing for me that I can't fight who I want to fight when I want to fight them. I would love to fight Manny Pacquiao, Timothy Bradley, some of those guys that are on the other side of the fence.
Now that Broner's a champ again, you know, he's got his four-time world champ thing, you know, is he like campaigning? Do you think he's going to go? Are there any talks of you and him having a rematch possibly?
Nah, we ain't rematching. I never thought that would happen anyway, but I looked at my dad one day and said, will we really rematch him? And my dad says, you know, one day, if it does make sense, we'll do it, but you know, he's not in our vision right now.
Is it more because he's such a high-profile fighter that you would even humor it, or is it?
Exactly.
Yeah, okay.
Exactly. You know, you take a look at the ins and outs in the business of boxing, and that's the part that I kind of lack, you know. You say my name, and I'm like, let's fight, you know what I mean?
But USA.
Hey, Manny Pacquiao maybe fighting Tim Bradley for the, what do you think?
I will fight for both, maybe for Pacquiao say goodbye boxing, maybe, but I think a good fight for the people.
You're a fighter that everybody loves to watch. You always fight. Who is next for you?
For my next is like I need for my next fight I get a win, and maybe after me win me say, hey Andrevero,
we're not rematch.
Yeah, you want to rematch with me? I am ready for you. But the first step is me win the. My next fight. Yeah.
Canelo Triple G, you win.
Man, that's fucking
big fight.
Yeah, big fight, and really, really, really like death for Canelo. But I think Triple G, 100%.
Okay, what about this one? Andre Ward, Kovalev.
Kovalev, Andre Ward. Nah, man. It's only like a hard fight. Not like two great fighters. but I seen an underwear.
Last question. Who's the pound for pound king right now after Mayweather and after Pacquiao? Who's number one in boxing?
Yeah, man, that's a last fighter. I know. I'm going to say who is the next Floyd Mayweather, but it's coming. One Floyd Mayweather.
You against Juan Manuel Marquez, who wins?
Nah, man. If we fight with Juan Manuel Marquez, I have all my respect for Juan Manuel Marquez, but I am training for win.
There you have it. Jesus Soto Carras. El Renuente.
El Renuente Soto Cara from Puto. Putos a la verga.
Puto.
Please do lifestyle.
Please do reporting.com. Release it back. Recording. So how does it feel to be honored tonight by Mia St. John? It's a big event, big award.
It feels great. I'm excited for the event. I mean, it kind of makes you feel like, you know, I'm still young, so it's the Lifetime Achievement Award is kind of older, but I'm excited and happy because I haven't been honored like this. I mean, Lifetime Achievement Award, I mean, ever. And for it to be Mia St. John, which was a great woman boxer, I'm definitely happy and excited.
Shane, wherever I talk to people in boxing, everyone loves you. Everyone has nothing but great things to say about you. Yeah. What's next for you?
Man, I'm going to go to Panama and I'm going to fight in honor of Gilberto Mendoza's father. I think now he has cancer. And I want to go out there and I'm going to do it for free. I'm going to go out there and fight a top 20 guy for free. In his honor. And in Panama. So after that, then we do some more fights. Maybe another one in England. Maybe some in England. Some in to fight. But this time it's at 147, which is my weight. I love it. I'm excited.
What do you think about Bradley Pacquiao 3? That's what it sounds like.
Interesting fight. That could be interesting. I mean, Bradley's very good. And Pacquiao, you know, they say he lost a little steam. So if he did, then maybe that could be a tough fight for both.
Perfect. Canelo sold 900,000 pay-per-view. What does that say?
Canelo's a bad man. I mean,
I liked his fight.
You know, I wasn't there in the arena. I mean, I heard people saying that Cotto won the fight. And watch on TV, like, Canelo won, and he looked great to me. He had speed, had power, ring generalship. He knew how to punch. I mean, he punched right. He did everything right, and I was proud of him. I thought he did a great job.
If Floyd comes back for 50th fight, would Shane Mosley want to fight him?
Of course.
What happens in that fight?
Oh man, I have like dynamite in my gloves, my fists. I'm knocking everybody out. Watch. Just see.
They're you all knock out Floyd.
I'm knocking everybody out. Floyd, anybody. I don't care who it is. Dynamite in his fist. And hard. Very hard.
What's the message to your fans? Sugar Shane Mosley?
Watch for me. I'm coming to take what's mine. Take over the business. Everything. You're going to see 147? You guys going to see. Watch. I'm gonna make you guys know why I'm Sugar Shane Mosley. All this talking about, maybe you can't do this or that. No. It's going to happen.
You look in shape.
Oh, I'm in shape. I'm ready. I'm in the gym all the time.
One fighter you would like to fight after your fight in Panama? Is it Kell Brook? Is it Marquez? Marquez is looking for a last fight.
Marquez is great. I'm going to fight Marquez. Who else was at 47? I mean, whoever. I mean, Manny Pacquiao and Mayweather. Both of those guys. I mean, I want all those guys. I want the best guys out there. I want to let people know that I'm not just coming here and fight for money or whatever. I'm coming to fight because I want to have the belt and want to be considered the best, and I'm going to make sure that you guys know that.
Alright, there you have it. Shane Mosley.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Sekpak. Back.